What's going on, guys? And yes, we are continuing our mining build, and today is all about connecting all the cables to the motherboard, the CPU, to get it up and running, and we could finally install Windows 10 on it and start mining cryptocurrency, right? So right now, I kind of twisted my power supply so you guys can see all the ports. I have all the cables and screws ready to install. All right, so we're going to start with the CPU first. We're going to connect the power, and we're going to connect this guy right here in this port. Awesome, done. We have another connector here. We also have to connect the coolant as well as the fan to this little controller right here. Again, this particular heat sink is just extremely complicated. So I'm going to take this cable right here, and we're going to start plugging everything in. All right, so we're going to take this connector right here, this little pin, and we're going to put it inside here. Make sure you don't put too much force because you don't want to bend it. It's pretty hard to get in there. Awesome. And then we're going to take this controller, right? You're going to take this controller right here, and we're just going to insert it like so. Awesome. Cool. Now with the three ends right here, we have three of them. I'm going to take this one right here. So this connector right here, I'm going to plug it into the connection that's, you know, connected to the CPU unit. And you actually have arrows. Just make sure you follow them. Let's plug that in. Cool. So that's done. We're going to take another cable from this controller, and one of the cables we are going to plug in the fan. So you got arrows, just make sure the arrows line up, and you're done. Awesome. Now the controller is extremely important because the controller has this little guy which you're going to plug in to power it on. So I am going to plug this guy in here. Like so. How easy was that? Then we have Molex connectors, which we are going to take power cables to plug it in here to power it on. And then last but not least, we have the CPU fan has a connector. So we actually got to connect it to the motherboard. So we are going to connect it right here, which is a system fan port. Awesome. Cool, cool, cool. Beautiful. Now, it's a lot of cabling. You're going to have one loose cable, which is okay. Don't freak out about that. But we need to give this guy, this unit, the CPU unit, because again, it's RGB. So you want it to like glow when it's turned on. So we got to connect a Molex connector. And the power supply does have one, which is this guy right here. And this connector goes right here. So we're going to connect it. And then behind the scenes, I am going to fix the cabling, tie it up. But for now, I want to show you guys where I'm connecting everything at. So I'm going to move the power supply a little bit there so you guys can take a closer look. And then you could take any Molex connector and just connect it like this, which this is what I'm going to do. And awesome. Boom. So technically the CPU has power. Now the next thing that we need to do is give the rest of the parts of our mining build power. So I am going to start with the following. I'm going to get the power supply and the motherboard cable. The motherboard connector is located right here. It's 24 pins. So I'm going to connect that guy right now. Awesome. Don't put too much pressure when you're connecting it. As long as you hear that clip, you're good to go. The other end is going to say PSU, power supply unit, and just connect it to the power supply unit. And that's what we're going to do. Awesome. Bingo, done. All right, again, don't freak out. The cabling is going to be rearranged behind the scenes. And next thing that we need to do is power our VGA, our graphics card. So this is the cable right here. You could do VGA 1 or VGA 2. I'm going to insert it inside VGA 1. And the other end, you're going to connect it on your power supply to power your graphics card. Boom, awesome. Now we need to power the CPU, so make sure you locate your CPU connector. And on the power supply, super self-explanatory, you got a CPU port, so we are going to plug that guy in. Now the other end, you need to locate the power port on the motherboard, and it's located right there, so let's insert that guy to power our CPU. Okay, so the last thing that I need to do is insert a hard drive, and I'm actually using a SATA hard drive from Western Digital. It's a 1 terabyte, keeping it super simple. Again, when you're mining, you don't really need like the best hard drive, and my main concern is the graphics card, and I might purchase another additional graphics card pretty soon. Stay tuned for that video. So I'm gonna take one of these guys here, and I'm going to just insert this hard drive. Super simple, look at that. Bam. I'm gonna put it back inside the cradle. Cool. So I already have the cables for the hard drive and SATA, right? We're gonna power it on. You have a port that says SATA 1, SATA 2. It's up to you. I am going to insert it into SATA 1. Excellent. And then from here, you're going to insert your SATA. So let's insert this guy. Bingo. Now, there's another cable that I need to get to actually insert it into the motherboard. And once I insert that, we actually have connection with the hard drive to the motherboard. And the last thing that I have is the memory. All right, so I'm going to open this guy up. I'm going to insert it in one of the slots, and then we should be good to go. We're going to push out all the drivers for the heatsink and for the motherboard and for the graphics card, and then we're going to install our mining software so we can start mining cryptocurrency. And before you guys head out, I am going to insert this 8 gig stick into our motherboard. So let's line this up. Again, I have to fix all this cabling. This cabling right now, the way it is, it's just driving me nuts. It's probably driving you guys nuts as well. But I just want to show you guys where everything is going to be inserted on the, you know, the power supply. Because if the power supply was rearranged correctly, you won't see, you know, where I'm inserting everything. So I am going to realign, make sure you got that notch. Realign it to the DIM on the motherboard. And then firmly on the left and right hand side, just push down until you hear the clip. Excellent. Two clips left and right, and we got the 8 gig stick already inserted, which is awesome. Cool. All right, so hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.